This video is brought to you by Clean My Mac X. So, you have a new Mac and you want to get the most out of it. Well, you've come to the right place. In this video, we'll go over some beginner's Mac concepts, tips and tricks, apps and even accessories that can help you get the most out of your machine. Everything I talk about, from items and accessories to deep dive materials like my beginner's macOS guides and others, will be linked in the description below. So, let's warm up with some useful basics around the macOS built-in features. One of the things that I cannot live without is screenshots, and the Mac is the king when it comes to that. You can take partial, app or window, and full screen screenshots by utilizing the buttons Command Shift plus 3 or 4. Command Shift plus 3 snaps the entire screen, while Command Shift plus 4 brings out the crosshair to select the desired portion of the screen. While in that mode, pressing spacebar will initiate the ability to take a screenshot of the entire app or window with a transparent background and even a beautiful shadow. Talking about apps, with the latest version of the Mac, you can turn any website into a web app. For example, YouTube Music doesn't have a native Mac app, so instead of keeping it active in Safari, you can simply open YouTube Music, go to Share, and add it to your dock. This will not only add it to the dock, but also in the app library, and next time you launch it, it will look super clean as if it's a native app. By the way, if you end up enjoying this video, consider subscribing, because why not? Another powerful feature of the Mac is to turn pretty much anything into a PDF. If you have an image or you have a print receipt, you can use the various built-in prompts to convert it into a PDF. Furthermore, if you select multiple images and other PDFs, you can group them into one by right-clicking and going to Quick Actions, Create PDF. While in that Quick Actions menu, you can take advantage of the built-in Remove Background feature to extract the subject of a photo out of its, surroundings, creating a very decent PNG image with transparency. With a Mac, you don't need to worry about archives either. The built-in archiver will not only allow you to open all zip files, but also you'll be able to archive galore by just selecting the file or files or folders and right-clicking to create an archive. The Option button of the Mac will open plenty of additional functionalities throughout the operating system, like holding Option and tapping on the clock to immediately activate Do Not Disturb mode, something that is very useful and handy while in meetings. If you're interested as to what else you can do with the Option button, I have a dedicated video which I'll link at the end of this one. Learning Mac's keyboard shortcuts will skyrocket your productivity, and I actually share some of the most useful shortcuts in both of my Mac tutorial beginners videos, so be sure to check them out below. A very basic shortcut that I'll mention here is using Command plus Space to summon Spotlight, as well as Command plus Option plus Shift plus V to paste text without formatting, which is an absolute bummer to witness in an email. If you prefer a more focused approach of using your Mac, consider turning on Stage Manager, which provides a more civilized way to handle multiple windows. A companion to the Stage Manager, or a solution on its own, would be to use multiple desktops which you can create a hot corner for. Of course, taking the best out of your Mac wouldn't be possible without utilizing Apple's ecosystem, the cornerstone of which is being iCloud and iCloud Drive. iCloud is a great cloud storage solution which I've used as my main service for years, where you can take advantage of features like shared desktop and documents folder to sync up across all the other Apple devices. Talking about other Apple devices, the Mac shines even more when working in tandem with the iPhone, with features like Universal Clipboard, which will allow you to copy and paste things between, those devices effortlessly. Oh, and let's not forget AirDrop, the ability to send any file back and forth in the means of dark magic. If you participate in a lot of meetings, then Continuity Camera will help you stand out by using the amazing rear cameras of your iPhone, which you can prop on the lip of the screen of your Mac with the help of a little MagSafe accessory like this one, and I'll get to accessories in a second. If you have an iPad, then consider using it in a dual on-the-go monitor setup with the help of Universal Control. Once you place the iPad next to your Mac, they will recognize each other and will allow you to extend the control of your Mac's trackpad and keyboard to the iPad. If you want to extend your Mac screen to the iPad, then Sidecar is your solution, which works wirelessly and out of the box. Simply go to Settings, Displays, and tap on the plus button to extend your Mac screen to the iPad. Getting the most out of your Mac also requires regular maintenance, and the app that can help you keep your computer in tip-top shape is Clean My Mac X. It's super intuitive to use, allowing you to declutter with just a simple press of a button that triggers the built-in smart scan feature, which does all the cleanup, malware removal, and speed up all in one. As I deal with large video files constantly, Space Lens is my favorite feature, allowing me to see what files are taking up most of my space. In the meantime, the menu app is the dashboard that I can just glance at whenever I want to see how much memory I'm using during, you know, video exports, how much storage I have left, my CPU load, battery temperature, internet connection speed, and more. Clean My Mac X helps uninstall apps the proper way as well, leaving no trace or residue files upon removal. Combined with the rest of the built-in tools, it wipes megatons of junk, handling the mess after every creative process. So embrace the mess and try Clean My Mac X with a 7-day free trial and 20% off by using my promo code ThisIsE and following the very first link in the description below. Moving on to a couple of other great apps, I have to mention Numi, which is the best inline calculator slash converter. It lives in the menu bar, and it will help you create all sorts of conversions and calculations on the fly. At the very least, it's super cool and minimal note taker on the fly. SuperList version 1.0 just came out, and it is my new favorite task slash to-do slash list creator app, which works across all of Apple devices and has a beautiful interface. The people of Wunderlist are behind this great app, which is free out of the box, and you can expand it, you know, to use as a team or just share with a significant other who, let's say, doesn't have an Android device because it works across all platforms. Now, I've always preached that a Mac can be as good as the accessories you pair it with. So with that in mind, let me start with some protective ones that you can think of, starting with the thinnest of them all, skins. I am a fan of the OG in that sector, D brand, and as soon as I got delivering my 14-inch M3 Max, I immediately dressed it for the occasion with D brand's deck water skin, which with this MacBook is an amazing combination if you ask me. A skin like that not only makes your Mac look unique, but most importantly, protects it from scratches and scuff when taking it in and out of backpacks or when placing it on surfaces. If you're working from coffee shops, a protective alternative to the skin would be a sleeve that you can also carry the laptop in while serving as a mat when placing it on a table. This carry sleeve from Moth, for example, does something extra, and that is elevating your Mac in a more ergonomic position while also keeping things, you know, safe down south. A more desk setup portable alternative would be OrbitKey's hybrid laptop sleeve, which from a classy carrying sleeve turns into a desktop mat with a dedicated space for your mouse. If you truly want to step it up a notch when it comes to stands, a fairly portable but very robust solution would be this Banks rotating laptop stand, which can accommodate pretty much all of the Mac laptops out there. It can be stored away or carried around as it collapses, while in the meantime serving as the greatest laptop riser with the ability to rotate the computer in, you know, very satisfying manner, while also tilting in any desired position, and all of this while providing proper cooling on the bottom. Since I am a clamshell user for the most part, I've had fairly rich experience testing different clamshell stands, and I'll start with a classic one that features a little twist. This stand is from Veidir and can probably be seen branded with other names. It is made from metal, and it is super sturdy while also providing extra side lips if you want to lean your tablet, for example. I've actually used that in a desk setup. If you prefer to truly elevate your laptop clamshell experience, literally, you can think in the direction of this laptop dock from Palolo, which is an accessory made for the company's setup cockpit shelf ecosystem. It really lifts up the laptop from the desk while keeping it secure in place, giving it that floating experience. Now, if you want to use the Mac in a dual monitor setup, Palolo also has the riser, which again mounts on the shelf itself, allowing you to flank your main monitor while still keeping things very floaty and minimal. By the way, Palolo have reached out to provide a 10% discount for you if you prefer to use the link in the description. Despite all the recent Pro Max featuring a decent amount of ports, you will inevitably end up having to plug a USB-A cable into the USB-C port of the Mac. The simplest accessory that you should equip yourself with is an adapter like this, which you can pick from many reputable brands like Anker, for example. Pick a pair, at least, or more, and keep them around for those moments. In my everyday carry, I also carry a 7-in-1 hub from Ugreen, which aside from the extra USB port provides SD slots as well as HDMI. This will come in handy if you have a MacBook Air, for example. If you use your Mac in a desk setup a lot, I strongly suggest investing into a decent dock as well. It will reduce the cable clutter while providing you with plenty of ports to create various single or dual monitor setups. A dock like this will give you the freedom to not only plug in a single cable into your laptop, but also drive displays, peripherals and speakers at the same time. At the studio, we use such docks from the company CalDigit, model TS4, which stands for Thunderbolt, and I'll be sure to link them below. All of Apple's OEM laptop chargers are okay, but I'd suggest you leaving them untouched in the box and upgrading to a GaN charger like this 100 watts one from Ugreen. It is half the size of most chargers while providing plenty of extra ports and not just a single USB-C. With Macs now being plenty powerful for gaming and offering amazing Apple Arcade titles, I suggest snatching a controller to have fun as well. I have two controllers to show you, both of them coming from a gaming company called 8-Bit Dough. The first one is called the Ultimate Controller, which is the best of what the company has to offer. It is customizable, being able to connect to pretty much anything, while coming with a charging station for that great Mac desk setup experience. For a more portable alternative, you can grab the Lite version, which is still customizable yet very slim and portable to carry around. Now, if you want something even smaller, then you can think in the direction of this cuteness overload of a controller, which I talk more about in this video right here. Like and subscribe to the channel as well as my newsletter, and as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.